with science to lead to increased transmission, and is now the dominant strain circulating in the UK. The South African strain of concern has also been found in a few other countries in Southern Africa. So in the last 1 week, we've had three reports of the UK variant of interest, the B117 strain, found in individuals that had left Nigeria and went to two other countries. And so once they were tested, this new strain was found among them within a week of returning from Nigeria. This was reported to us through the international health regulations, and it's most likely that these strains were acquired in Nigeria. This morning as well, in collaboration with our partners, the Africa Center for Excellence in Genomics in Ede, like I said, we sent 50 samples to them. I reported to you last 2 weeks ago. One of those samples came out to have that variant of interest, the UK variant of interest that is linked to increased transmission. So what does this mean? I mean, it's not surprising that we're finding these strains in Nigeria. We know there's a lot of travel between these two countries. We've also seen increased transmission in Nigeria. It's likely that it is one of the reasons. Definitely not the other reason, because of the increased activities we saw here over Christmas. So we're going to keep intensifying our genomic surveillance to look out for more of these. It's difficult for us to scale rapidly. Sequencing is a very complex endeavor, but we're working with our partners now to scale our sequencing. There are three institutions that have significant sequencing capacity in Nigeria: ASGID, like I mentioned, ourselves, and the Nigeria Institute for Medical Research in Yaba Lake.